escalates his tariff fight with China. Allison Kosick on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange. Market set to open in just about 20 seconds. What are you seeing?
Okay, so you expect to see the Dow drop over 300 points at the open pop. You know, investors really expected to see the trade rhetoric die down. Instead, they're seeing it intensify. It began on Friday when President Trump promised to stop China with $50 billion worth of tariffs beginning July 6th. And then he upped the ante to an additional $200 billion when China promised it would retaliate. So that's why you're seeing the market spook today. The Dow right now down 300 points at the open because there's concern about where this will end, if this will end, if this will turn into an all-out trade war. Keep in mind, no tariffs have been implemented except on steel and aluminum at this point. At this point, it's rhetoric. But the rhetoric alone is really undermining confidence here in the stock market. You really see it in some of the stock prices for some of the big American companies like Boeing and Caterpillar falling at the open as well. Intel taking a big hit as well. Did you know that those Intel chips are made here in the U.S., but then they're shipped to China to be tested and assembled and then shipped back here to the U.S.? So guess who's going to get hit with those tariffs if they take effect? Yes, Intel, those chips, that could affect your computer prices. Oh, and by the way, if those $200 billion in tariffs actually take effect, consumers are likely to feel it in their own pockets. I'm talking about American consumers. Americans are big consumers of Chinese goods, everything from clothing to shoes to makeup. And if those exports from China are taxed, Americans are going to have to dig deeper in their pocketbooks. As we take another look at the numbers, the Dow down 315 points. If the Dow closes at this level at the end of the day, Poppy, the Dow will be in the red for the year. All of its gains wiped out. Poppy?
All right, Allison on the floor of the exchange, appreciate it. This is what it looks like when a global trade war is brewing, if not underway. Heather Long is with me, economics reporter for The Washington Post. She has written extensively on this. Heather, thank you for being here. Allison just gave a really interesting example of Intel chips and what it could cost American consumers. Talk to me about the average American. Why do they care about this? What does this mean for them?
If President Trump goes forward with these tariffs, American consumers will feel it. Early estimates are that it could hit the average American family, cost them about $200 to $250 more a year. So that's not nothing if these tariffs do go into effect. What do we buy a lot of from China? We buy TVs, we buy cell phones, we buy kids' sporting equipment. So if these tariffs go into effect, families are going to go to the store and they're going to face higher prices for those items. You saw last night, right after President Trump announced these additional tariffs or his intent to do more tariffs, the retail, the store federation was the first to come out and say this was a terrible idea.
So give me a gut check here, Heather, because China comes out this morning and says we will, quote, strike back hard. And you know they will, if history is any indication. If this isn't a trade war, what is a trade war?
It's sure looking a lot like a trade war. Seeing as Allison Kosick was saying, we're not quite there yet, and the only reason I say that is the tariffs had yet to go into effect. That first round of tariffs won't go into effect until early July. So at the moment, we are still in this weird war of words phase, but if these tariffs do go into effect, this additional $200 billion means that half of the imports the United States buys from China would be subject to a tariff. And Trump has threatened to go even higher than that and do almost all of the imports from China, have them be subject to a tariff. That's a scale we haven't seen since the 1930s.
Why do you think the market is reacting this way this morning? I mean, the Dow off 300 points so far. You know, the rhetoric we've had from this president on tariffs on China, even the official announcements the White House has made on implementing these tariffs, have not always sparked a sell-off. I mean, is this the tariffs combined with the Fed warning of more rapid rate increases? What is this?
I think there's a real change in what we saw last night from the Trump administration. For the past few weeks, it was just this war of words. It was Trump sort of shaking a stick at China and China shaking its fist back. It was a lot of rhetoric. It was a lot of play and puffing up of chess. But what we've seen that's different now is that President Trump is implementing tariffs. He's implementing it on our allies, on Canada, on the European Union, and now he's putting the hammer down hard on China. And the big question is, how does this end. At the moment, both sides, both leaders, President Trump and Chinese President Xi, want to be perceived as strong leaders.
Right.
They're not going to cave right away to each other when there's this kind of threats going on. That doesn't look good for them politically.
It doesn't. Heather Long, appreciate the reporting from the Washington Post. Thank you. Nice to have you.
Thank you.
All right, so ahead for us, just a few feet away from the border, migrant families wait, hoping their name will be called. Next, our Gary Tuchman on the border talking to mothers who wonder what will happen to their children.